This next one. Plenty of history was made on the offensive side of the ball in New Orleans Sunday. Drew Brees and Eli Manning combined for a single game record, 13 pass TDs, and combined for 101 points, basketball score, tied for the third most points by both teams in NFL history. Stephen A., what was your takeaway from that ridiculous shootout?
Honestly speaking, my takeaway from the game, the first thing that came to my mind was both defensive coordinators should be forced to fly commercial home. They shouldn't be allowed.
I thought you said they should be fired.
No, okay. Because, I mean, obviously they ain't giving up 52 every week or 49 every week. But both defensive coordinators, Spagnuolo and, of course, Rob Ryan, should not even have been allowed. In Spagnuolo's case, don't even get on a team plane. In Rob Ryan's case, you know what, just make him walk home. I mean, it's like literally you literally owe your owners a check. For this week, you know, because you clearly didn't show up on the job unless you apply for vacation and you tap it onto your vacation. You did nothing. There was no defense. I mean, the Giants defense yesterday was so embarrassing. I mean, how many times did Drew Brees throw a touchdown? I know he had 7 touchdown passes, but how many times did he throw a touchdown pass? And you literally saw the Giants defense looking around at one another like, what happened? You were supposed to be there. You were supposed to be. I mean, it's almost like they didn't show up to work. They just showed up in New Orleans for a game. And then the next thing you know, this kind of stuff happens. Of course, Drew Brees was sensational. Eli Manning showed up. Odell Beckham Jr. had a 100-yard-plus game. He showed up. Mm-hmm. We see what was happening here. But there was literally no defense. It looked like a Big 12 game, for crying out loud. No defense whatsoever. And by the way, Tom Coughlin should be ashamed of himself, too. This man has a defensive background. This man has credentials. He's a 2-time Super Bowl champion. Yep. And talk about the identity of the New York Giants. When they won Super Bowls, it was all about their defense. Mm-hmm. With Parcells, with Tom Coughlin, okay? Led by Strahan or Justin Tucker or these boys. It didn't matter. You saw a defense. Never in my wildest dreams did I think we'd see a big blue team that was so god-awful defensively. I don't care who's hurt. I'm not even going into all those semantics. Mm-hmm. How could you look that bad?
Yeah.
They were atrocious to the point where it doesn't even make sense to me to talk about a Drew Brees or to talk about an Eli Manning because it really, really, really doesn't matter. This Giants team that I saw ain't winning the NFC East.
Yep.
It's not happening. You got to be able to play defense. It's now, to me, after yesterday's performance, it's back to being about Dallas and Philadelphia, more so Philadelphia than Dallas, for obvious reasons, which we'll get into a little bit later. Mm-hmm. But in the end, the Giants, I don't care about their 4-4 record. I don't care about the fact that they're in first place. You can't play defense like that win. That was just embarrassing. That's all I took from it. I just sat up there and watched. It's like, this is not an NFL game. Mm. And if it were college, you're excited about it. But there's something about it being an NFL game that just turns you off. Mm. That you looked at the NFL and you literally said to yourself, these are supposed to be professionals. Mm. How do you look? Even when New England dropped 50 on Jacksonville didn't look like that. You know, you just got methodically picked apart by a clearly superior team. No, in the case of the Giants against the Saints, it literally looked like both teams decided not to play defense.
The 29th and 30th ranked defense going into it, total defense.
I mean, I couldn't believe how bad they looked. I really couldn't.
Did the game count?
Yes.
It goes in the standings,
right? It goes
right?
in the standings.
Okay, I want to make sure of that because you said it didn't look like an NFL game.
It did.
And by the way, before I launch on this,
gosh.
Molly is threatening to unfollow me
on
Twitter.
I trolled him last night.
I thanked the Saints for winning that game for me and my Cowboys, and in it, I wrote Giants in all lowercase letters.
And everything
like
else
little
in
Giants.
Caps. Mm-hmm.
Okay.
This is obnoxious.
She's going to unfollow me over
there. Yeah, it was obnoxious.
That's fine. Okay, here's my takeaway. No team that gives up 52 points deserves to win the NFC East. I'm sorry, no team.
Right.
So that was my number one takeaway. And number two, because the game did count in the standings, dropping the Giants to, 4-4?
First place.
Now, somehow, some way.
Oh, God.
Embarrassingly enough for the division, my Dallas Cowboys are still only one game out of first place in the loss column. Only one game out of first place in the loss. Are you kidding me? And, you know, my other takeaway was that the ultimate new accident waiting to happen in pro football is your New York Giants. How did they lose that opening game at Jerry World?
And then follow that up by losing.
And they lost to the Falcons. And the Falcons are starting to get exposed as just pretty good. Not great, not dominant. They're just pretty good. They lost at home to Tampa. They almost lost at home to the Redskins. Remember that? So they're getting exposed.
Yes.
They're coming back to earth quickly. And yesterday, the New York Football Giants managed to blow this game on a face mask penalty by the punter.
By the punter.
By Brad Wing. The punter. Here he is. He gets a face mask as the ball is fumbled forward.
This is Cowboys-esque.
This is Cowboys-esque.
Yeah.
This is old Cowboys. Mm. Previous Cowboys-esque. These are the Cowboys you used to laugh at, scoff at, ridicule for being the accident waiting to happen. And now it's Brad Wing. Brad Wing, he gets a face mask. And all of a sudden, they've got a 50-yard field goal, and the new kicker hits it. And the game is over. And here's the God's truth of what happened yesterday. Your Giants didn't deserve to win this game because your Giants were 1 out of 8 on third down. In this shootout, they still were only 1 of 8 on third down. And when you look at the total yards, your Giants had 416, which is really good. The other team's got 614, so almost 200 fewer yards do your Giants have than Drew Brees and company, right?
Yeah.
And the Giants did have one defensive touchdown on the fumble return, 63 yards. Okay, so you hang in. That actually puts you ahead. But the home team had 2 turnovers, and the Giants only had 1 turnover.
Yeah.
So I look at what happened. Your Giants were lucky to be in the game and then incredibly unlucky to blow the game. In the end, they come back to the pack. And the truth is, the NFC East, halfway through, it hasn't even started yet, right? It's like it's up for grabs now. It's still, I don't know, the Washington Redskins could win the NFC East for all I know.
Yeah, well, listen, they're only a game back.
That's what I'm saying.
They're only a game back. I mean, it's again, Dominique Rodgers-Cromartie, I want to sort of omit him from this conversation because he makes plays. He's had 3 interceptions in the last 2 weeks. He finds a way to keep himself actively involved.
Yeah.
I get all of that, but I mean, this is some embarrassing stuff here. And you expect no, I mean, you should be ashamed of yourself. You're Rob Ryan. I don't care that you won. You should be ashamed of yourself. You're Rob Ryan. Your defense. I mean, talk about somebody that lost his luster. I mean, think about it. Once upon a time, we just sat there and said if he lost some weight and got a haircut, you know what? He could be a head coach. He could be a head coach. Gotta look the part. Gotta show up to work, look a professional. Get a haircut. Go to a salon, or in his case, a salon, not a barbershop. And just get the haircut. Do whatever.
Okay.
Whatever you need to do.
Yeah.
But then you look at this defense and the way that it has played, particularly yesterday too. Just no excuse whatsoever. And the Giants didn't even run the football. Everything was with their passing attack. And you just looked at it, and somehow, some way, despite throwing 6 touchdown passes, 350 yards. I mean, what is it here? You know, a rating of 138.
Yeah.
Somehow, some way, Eli Manning still lost this game.
He lost the game.
The New Orleans, listen, New Orleans defense is bad. It was bad yesterday. But the Giants were so embarrassing because, again, at least when New Orleans got beat, there was somebody in the vicinity.
Yep.
I mean, you look at the Giants, it was like, literally, got, who was it that scored the one touchdown where he's just strolling in? When he just strolled in. I mean, who was, I mean, and it was, I mean,
and
literally walked in.
It was wide
looking behind,
open.
And
I know
it's like, oh, there's
about.
Nobody near me.
Nobody's home.
He literally could have walked. The
most
last
yards allowed since 1943 by the Giants.
I don't even understand it. I really don't understand it. He literally could have walked the last 30 yards.
Yeah.
Walked.
Was that fun for you? Did you enjoy that?
Great time. That was my great moment of the day.
Yeah. How about those Cowboys? We'll talk about
Colston.
Them. Colston.
It was Colston. Yeah.
Man,
I'm just saying. I just looking at him. He's like he couldn't believe how wide open he was.
Yeah.
It was just embarrassing, man. And like I said, it's an NFL game. You don't anticipate seeing something like that. That
it's
was
ugly.
Just bad.
Okay.
The NFC
as long as we don't have to talk about the Cowboys today, I'll be happier.
Right.
Of course we're talking about the Cowboys today. Of course.
Oh, well,
I'll
lay out of this one.
Right.
I'll let Stephen A. handle it.
Please. The NFC is looking like the AFC South. It's bad.
Right.
In a battle of Skip and Stephen A. Super Bowl teams, the Cowboys lose a close one at home to the Seahawks. The Cowboys lost again, Skip. Don't miss the guy's reaction. And we're here for your Monday motivation. Check us out on our IG page right now where I give you the complete rundown. Oh, it's been a long, long time since the Cowboys won. Look at that video right there. That looks exciting. Can't wait to go to Instagram.